Hi guys, in this lecture you will be learning positioning. So first of all, what is the positioning? You can use the positioning property to align or position any HTML element in any position at any position in the page. So here I have already created a div and I have given it the background color, width and the height and the border, and now here I'm gonna create another div and then I will give it the position property. Then you can understand it clearly. Here it is, this is the second div, and now here I'm gonna give the class to this div, right class, and here I'm gonna give it AB class, and then here to the second div I'm also gonna give it the class, here it is AC class, and now this style is going to be applied on AB. Here is the AB, and now I'm gonna copy this style and then change it to give this style to the AC. Here it is, and here is AC, and now I'm gonna change its background color to the yellow. And here I'm gonna give it 200 width, yellow have the 200 width, and here you see that this yellow div is present here, but when we give the position property and then it have four values, so we can align it at any place, we can change its position. So first of all, here is the position property to write position, and then it have four values. First value is static, so static is the default value. Here you see that this div have the static position, it also have the static position, so all the default positions of the HTML elements are the static position, so we don't need to discuss the static position because it is the default. Now the second thing is the absolute. It is important, we will use it. In the absolute value, when we give the absolute value to any HTML element, so that HTML element will override other HTML element, and we can place the HTML element at any place in the page. It will be displayed on the top of the elements. Or in other words, you can say that when we give absolute value to any HTML element, so that element can override any other HTML element. So now I'm gonna give the absolute position to this yellow div, and now let's start. Here I have given it absolute position, and now I'm gonna align, or I'm gonna give it the different position. Here is, we are able to give the top, what is the distance from the top to this div. Here I'm gonna give 200 pixel or reduce it 200 pixel, and then we can also give the distance from the left side. Here I'm gonna give 30 pixel from the left side, and then you can also give the distance from the bottom side. Here is, I'm gonna give the 50 pixel, and here is the distance from the right side. So you can give the top, left, bottom and right distance to the all the four values of the position, and here I'm gonna give 60 pixel, and now let's watch it. So here you see that now this div have that 200 pixel from the top, 30 pixel from the left, 50 pixel from the down, 60 pixel from the right. This is the effect of the absolute value. So now you can see that it override this div, or in other words you can say that, you can also say that it cannot feel any effect of other HTML elements, And now here I want to tell you something, that the 200 pixel from the top is started from this boundary, is started from this line, and the 30 pixel from the left side is started from this boundary from on the left side, and the bottom side is started from their boundary, and right side distance is started from its boundary. So all the distances are from its boundaries. And now here I want to tell you another interesting thing, that is the Z index. We can give the Z index to show an HTML element on the top or below. Here you see that this yellow div is shown on the top and this red div is shown on the below. So why it is shown on the top this yellow? Because it have the greater Z index, it have the greater stack order, and it have the lower. So I'm gonna give the Z index so we can show it on the top or the below. Here what we need to do, we want to show this red div on the top, so we have to give it the Z index. Here I'm gonna give it Z index. You can write any number in the Z index. Here I'm gonna write 5, you can write 100, 700, 10 or anything. So now it red div have the 5 Z index. So now we want to show this red div on the top of the yellow. So that's why we have to give the lower Z index to the yellow div. We have to give it lower value than the 5. Here I'm gonna give it 4. So now this yellow div, so now this red div have the greater z index, so that's why it shows on the top. Here it's not working. Why it's not working? Here we have to give the position absolute to both divs. Here I have not give to the red div, so that's why. So now it have the greater Z index, it have the lower, so the greater Z index is shown on the top. Here you see that this red div have the greater value, so that's why it shows on the top. And if we give it lower value than the 4, here you see that it have the 4, so now here it is shown on the top. So now the third value is the relative. In the relative, when we give the relative position to any HTML element, then that element move with respect to the first position. In the absolute position, you see that this div is move from the boundaries, it have the distance from their boundary, it have the distance from the left side boundary. So now when we give the relative position, so the HTML element will be move from its last position. And now here I'm gonna create a HTML heading, then you can understand it clearly. Here I'm gonna remove this. Here is remove it. Here I'm gonna make it in the heading. Here is the h1, and here it's, I'm gonna also gonna change its opening tag, and here I'm gonna increase it. So now here are 4 or 5 headings, and now here I'm gonna give it the class AC. So now I'm gonna change the position of this h1 class, and here I'm gonna remove the style for the AB on all the headings, and here I'm gonna cut this. First I will show you simply. Here you see that here are the headings. So now I'm gonna move this third heading. I'm gonna move this third heading who have the AC class. So now here I'm gonna give it, here it is absolute, it have the yellow background and all the things, and here I'm gonna change its Z index. And in this relative position, we are able to give the top position, left position, bottom position and all the things. First I'm gonna remove it. I'm gonna remove these two things, and now top have the 100 pixel and the left have the 30 pixel. So now here you see that. Here I'm going to remove the background color, then you can understand it clearly. And now here is, remove it. And now here I'm going to remove this top. I will give these values later. So now it have the relative position, third heading and left from the 30 pixel. And here you see that this heading is move 30 pixel from the left. But when we give the absolute position, so the element will be move according to the boundary. Or in other words, when we give the absolute position, so the element move the distance or element increase or decrease the distance from its boundaries, or from left boundary or right boundary or bottom on the top. If we give the absolute position and we give the 30 pixel, so it will be moved from this position to the 30 pixel. But here you see that it have the relative position, so it moves according to its first position. Its first position is started from this, so it will be moved on the left side 30 pixel. And here I'm gonna increase it, then you can understand it clearly. Here you see that this line is move from this position to the 90 pixel on the left side. So this is the relative position, element move according to the first position, according to the last position. This is its first position and last position, you can call it anything. And now I'm gonna give it top 20 pixel. So now here it is. Here you see that it moves 20 pixel down from its previous position. And if we give it, we can also give it bottom. Here is the bottom. Here I'm gonna give it the bottom 30 pixel. And here it is. You cannot see the effect of the bottom right now. And here is the right. And here it is. Here if we have some text on its right side, so that's why then we will see the effect of the right and the bottom, but it will be work. And the next value is fixed. So now here I'm gonna increase these divs and then I will give the fixed value. Here it is and here it is. And now these divs are increased, and here I'm gonna increase it more. Here it is. And now these headings are too much. But now here you see that here I'm gonna give style. Here I'm gonna give a different class to the third heading. I'm only gonna use this class, that is AE. And I'm gonna give it the background. Here is the background is red. And now let's check it. So now here is the heading, I have given it the background red, and when I scroll down the page, so it will be disappear. Here you see that it is gonna be disappear. But if we want to show this heading continuously, or we don't want to disappear this heading when we scroll down the page, so what we need to do, we have to fix this heading on the page, then it will not move at any place. Here I'm gonna give it position fixed. If we give it position fixed, so now refresh this page, and now here you see that it is fixed on its default position. We are scrolling the page, but it is still present. And the next thing is it is on this place, you can position this heading at any place in the page by giving the top, left and right and bottom. Here I'm going to give it top. Here is top 200 pixel, and left is also 200 pixel, and here it is. So now here you see that it is now fixed at this position. So this is the positioning. If you have any problems currently at the discussion, I will help you as much as I can. Thank you for watching this video. I will see you in the next video.